See what we got. Something for Hosea. Bill Williamson. Bill needs to speak to you. Right now, how about Bill? Can't funds, $5.
My, what a charade you are playing, dressed as the law.
I'll get on those debts.
Good, good.
They better be.
Oh, which reminds me, I need to know how much cash I got. 152, that should be enough to pay my debts.
Hi.
Well, then he's ours, I guess. For now.
Aww. That's so great. Hey, boy. Aww.
We got a doggo.
Well, he's a wanderer. He probably did something bad. Cain. His name is Cain.
Okay. Hey, Cain. Whoa. What did Cain do?
A real bad thing. So he never stopped wandering.
I'll give 50 or 20 or something. In the ledger, we can restock. Actually, I need to find a post office and collect those debts. We got a debt here. Debt here. I'm gonna go to a post office, pay off my debt. Bring back the money, help out Bill, and then we'll be fine. Alright, and then my personal ambition will be a better horse. And then...
You behaving there, O'Driscoll?
I'm not an O'Driscoll, sir.
Sure. How are the horses?
Okay. But they could be better. I'm worried. They've been through a lot. If I had some burdock root, just a couple, I could knock up a poultice, could keep them well, and cure some ailments.
Burdock root?
Yes, that works best.
Okay. If I see some, I'll bring it you.
Well, thank you, sir.
Burdock root.
Come on, people, it's ready!
I'm already full. Me and Billy. We go on an adventure. First to pay off my debt. Then, To go steal other people's debt. Yep, sounds about right. I gotta go pay some debts, to stake some debts. Oh man, the irony. Oh. What? I'm gonna go skim through this area.
Okay there, boy.
Yep.
Something going on over here?
Anyone move? I go right before I shoot you. Hurry up and nail.
You're free. And that kid is how you save the day. There we go. Had to kick him to the floor. Silver. My, these brainers are packing. Platinum.
Let's go, boy.
Honestly, other people's robberies are like 90% of my profits.
This whole town knows you, for sure.
Hey there, mister.
You gonna behave this time?
I ain't looking for trouble, I assure you.
Saved your life.
All the best now.
God be with you.
Pay off all my debts. Please.
Wait your turn. Almost done. Run up a tab now, have we?
There went all my money.
Thanks, partner.
Oh well. Is there a fence near here? Yeah, I can hit him up. Try some of those bangles.
Mister.
Welcome, mister. First time in my shop.
What? What?
Second mind about something? Sure. Let me see. Hell, you really want to get rid of this? No questions asked.
A freaking machete and some beans.
Near got bit by a goddamn dog this morning. Not enough food for anyone. This is the place to come to.
Holy crap, these fences are running like a heck of an operation. I might take that.
Really? You won't regret it.
I won't ask too many questions. Thank you for your help.
If I ever need the ropes on, I don't need to shut the door open now.
Yep.
Alright. Time to go practice banking. I'm poor.
Yeah.
Oh, I was gonna be like, that's the sun? Like, no, that's just gonna...
You're a good boy.
Yeah.
I'm not gonna mess with that. Got a problem with me, huh? Don't shoot at me. Also, thank pleasure doing business with you. platinum pocket watch. Alright. Come here, Wishy. They're gone now. Oh, look it, those guys just tried assassinating me twice, and they both just made me get more money. Oh, I love repeaters. Ow, dude, what are you on? I've noticed not as many animals pose a threat to my horse, because like I used to be always attacked by mountain lions all the time back in my dead one. I have been attacked by bears, but most of the time I was looking for the bears, so fair game.
Such a goddamn performance with you. Now, I told you I'd get you the money next week, and I'll get it.
If you didn't make it this week, who's to say you'll make it next?
Don't you...
Lily! Where's our money?
What?
That loan you took. It's payday.
I'm sorry. I don't have it right now.
Well, then. I guess we got a big problem, don't we?
Cooper! Give him what you've got.
I ain't giving him nothing. Except a lessening.
Damn mother! Bitch!
So who's next on my list? We got you, and then two other people.
I didn't steal that, it's a death.
Pay for my money.
You're lucky. He was here to pay for you, miss.
I wouldn't have had to borrow it if he wasn't. Now stay the hell away from me.
Find that witness.
kill you, I swear! Stop, you fool! Now!
You're about to get your face broke!
You know what? Just go. You forget what you...
Psycho! Whoa! Do this. There you are.
Settle down, boy. Here you are, boy.
Oof, I need something to eat myself.
Come on now, boy.
Oh, damn. Someone's got the lights on. I think somebody's home. Knock, knock.
You Chick? I was told I could find a Chick Matthews up here.
Chick Matthews? Might want to talk to that fella over there. Nah, I'm just here to work for the season.
You Chick Matthews?
Oh, no, not me, sir. That's the greenhorn over there. And there he goes.
So long, long shark.
Damn it! Hey! Get back here! You owe us money!
You cannot run from your death! He can run from his death! Jeez, this boy is fast!
On the line.
Look, I got the money, but it's hidden. Untie me, and I'll tell you where it is. There ain't no reason to...
Goddamn treasure hunt? You're lucky I ain't taking your teeth as well.
Save me! You got the map. Do the decent thing. Aren't you gonna untie me?
I think I just
You'll
did.
Find it there. Everything. I'll find it.
Yep.
I said it was in the tree. Just one more. A heck of a distance away. Right.
Yep.
Yeah, no, this is the best one. Good on it then.
Easy now. Thank you.
guess I'm gonna have to cook it.
Easy, easy.
What far away is this for?
I need some money. Can't you help a fella out?
Partner?
Hey, Morning. Brother.
Hey, you made it all the way
Mister,
over here.
Mr. Arthur. Why are you always so mad? You're crazy. All that shooting. And they said I was crazy. I'm not crazy. Not like you. You beat up the big fella. He once beat me up. I asked for it. You think you're real crazy, mister?
Are you really calling me crazy?
I fought in a war, mister. I did. Sent me strange seeing all them fellas die.
Which war was that exactly?
A bad one, Mr. Arthur. Oh, a real bad.
There's good wars?
I saw terrible things. I ain't been the same since. I get funny. I'll go now. Don't act crazy now.
All right, Nikki. Wait a minute. This is Valentine. Can I pick up my sheet?
Hey, fellas. Good morning.
Everything okay?
All right.
Appreciate you stepping in there. Those bastards been turning the screw on me from day one, saying I gotta pay them protection money. I told them where to stick it, and well, I guess you just saw how that panned out. You watch yourself, right? Stay out of trouble.
I'll try.
Horace. Oregano. This stuff's good.
Let's go, boy.
Still got some distance.
Well, shit!
Warning, mister.
Talking now, huh? I knew this thing was trouble. Still, trouble's profit for me. Oh, and just to send a message. It was an accident.
Hey, boy.
Yeah. Seriously, when will these guys learn? I think I'm actually getting a boss finally. Sorta.
Hey there!
Sweet Juniper and Boiled Satan, you scared me!
Boiled Satan? Yeah, I get that a lot. So, what's that you got there?
You ain't interested in no scrap paper. It's nothing. Just something for wiping and sniffing in the night. Yeah.
Well, hey, why the hurry, partner?
I got a hottail. Don't you follow me now.
You're not worth my time. It's also got the witnesses. There's a graveyard.
Went homes?
I didn't expect to run into no one out here.
Funny how far a man's debts will follow him. You got some money for me, boy? I seen your name in our ledger.
You're with the German? Look, I got it for you. It's just, I don't got it yet. It's up in them hills.
Mm. You panning for?
Hunting it. I tracked this cougar. It's rare. Lily-white coat. The pelt will more than cover what I owe.
If I'm skinning anything, I'm skinning you, boy.
Please. I'm out of work. It's the only way you'll get paid, and all the hard work's already done.
Fine. Move.
We'll, need our horses. It's, quite a trip.
Yeah. All right. Drive, boy. Let's get where we're going. Drive!
Okay, follow me.
Drive!
I'm driving.
Make me come out here, make me chase all over this goddamn mountain.
Hey, you knew it was a risk.
I didn't know nothing. Your name's all I knew.
Well, the German-speaking fella then, Mr. Strauss, he knew my work situation was precarious, that this whole thing was a risky venture.
Wait, risky? I'm at risk now? Are you threatening me, Winton Holmes?
I ain't. No, certainly not. Sir, I'm merely stating, a man without a job, with limited prospects, at those rates, repayment was by no means guaranteed. I said I'd do my best, and I did.
You're continuing to annoy me.
We're going right here, up the stream.
Hey, how about this thing? I guarantee you pay. Because I'm going to get that money out of you. If I got to squeeze you like a lemon, it's coming out.
Yeah, of course. We're onto it now, okay? We're onto it now. The cash is in that cougar, mister. Sure, as pumpkins ain't cauliflowers, the cash is in that cougar.
It better be, or I'll turn you into a goddamn cauliflower.
Up here, we ain't too far now. What I know about cats, this one's rare as hen's teeth. I mean, you ever seen an alabaster wildcat?
Big thing about cougars is they see you. Not the other way around.
That may be, but you'd see this one. I've been hunting with my pa. Shot all kinds of cats. Never one like this. In another life, I'd have sought my fortune outdoors. Not in the hot, stinking belly of a tar pit.
I ain't interested in your regrets or your life story, Mr. Holmes. Just your damn money. Drive.
Damn. So you brought a coat?
This is it. Her den. We should leave the horses. Soon. Quiet now. Won't be able to miss her shining in the dark. You hear that? There's a cougar in here. And I bet she's white as virgin cotton. The tunnel diverges up here. I'll take the left, you go right, and we'll see if we don't converge down a ways. And look out for her.
Yeah.
Not one bit. possible to have both of this thing yet? Damn! I'm going with the guy.
What you doing? You're meant to be going the other way.
So I have to use both my lantern and my pistol. God dang, she's fast.
Oh!
Freaking hell.
It's white. Better be rare.
Damn near peed myself.
Get out of here, horse. Your man ain't coming. I ain't in a chivalrous mood. Scoot, boy. Get going, girl. Come on, pal. Yep.
Seriously, what the hell was that trip? Strauss owes me a lot of money. You okay, Dewey? $48.
Done. Thank you. Really.
I almost hopped on in someone else's ride. Did I get it right? We got some distance, right? You okay? Yeah, you get okay. Yeah, you get it. You get the poop. So I'm actually not too far away since I'm in the southern region, but still. Onward! Oh, I should see if there's anything I can hunt on the way over. Perfect skin.
Whoa, you're okay, boy.
He literally shat himself.
Tumbleweed. All right, go on and make tracks, huh?
All right, easy now.
See, dude.
I'll settle down.
We're about to pass through the territory.
That's it.
looks ginormous, almost the size of the horse.
Not bad hunt, huh, boy? Yep.
Alright. Well, camp's eating tonight. In the state now, at least. Ugh, the deer's slowing me down.
You! Stay right there and don't move!
You got a bullet coming, you don't stop. Still.
This here's a hold up, you know what to do.
Yeah.
Why don't you stretch your legs, huh?
Got me. And someone that gives a high amount of health. Tonics.
Oh shit, I ain't ready to die yet.
Oh, you didn't seem to think that through. About that.
This is very kind of you.
You want to think about this?
Okay. Great conversation. Platinum pocket watch again. Nice, guys. Never doubt the powers of Deadeye.
Ooh.
Oh, no, that's Bill.
We need to talk to you.
Not right now. Got some fishing to do.
There she is.
So what? You're a deputy now?
Bring me something soon if you can, Arthur.
All right, Jerry. Can't wait to taste this. Many thanks, Cool Morgan.
Okay, Mr. Morgan.
He's no wind, son. He is a seer. He sees things we don't know yet. I know I'm just evil. You're just afraid of opening your mind because you might not like what you find. You're probably right.
You know, you always have the most incredible way of putting things.
Hi, Uncle Arthur.
That's the way of putting things.
Hi.
I'm just an old outlaw, not prepared to go quietly.
Nothing can stop me and my coffee addiction.
What are you doing?
Going fishing. The rivers around here, famous for the smallmouth bass. Fella I met showed me a couple spots. You want to join me?
I can't fish with you. You're far too good.
Oh, come on. Hey, join me. I'll show you a couple of my tricks. There's a spot not too far from here that I've been wanting to try out.
Glad you're so excited about this.
You will be too when you start pulling out smallmouth. Come on. The fish should be hungry for their dinner.
I thought you said it wasn't far.
Too far to walk, though. Yeah, come on.
Been a while since we rode out, just you and me.
Mm-hmm. Probably since we went looking for John on the mountain.
Already seems long ago. How you feeling about everything? Been a strange couple of months.
Hey, you know, I can't even return to my country because the price on my head is so big. This is nothing exactly new to me. And I'll always be loyal to Dutch. He sees the world the same as I do. If we have to fight, we fight. If we have to run, we'll run. If we must die, we'll die, but we'll stay free.
And Dutch, you don't feel like, well, that he's doing things a little differently now? You saw what happened with that girl on the ferry.
No fight, good or bad, is won without blood. I know that better than most. I think too many people are focusing on Dutch when they should be looking at themselves, what they could have done better.
Maybe you're right.
Careful! We'll cut through to the right here. The other day, I rode down to the Lanahatchee River. I caught some beautiful steelhead trout.
You mean the Lanahatchee River?
No. The Lanahatchee. It runs right near here.
Yeah, but it's pronounced Lanahatchee.
Oh, no.
Why is everything in English said differently than it's written? Make us feel stupid?
Oh, you're asking the wrong fella.
Okay, it's just down the hill here. Come on, let's go try our luck.
pretty country.
Beautiful.
Come on, let's go see what's biting. You take it.
Not again.
I'm going to cast from over to the right there, so we're not in each other's way. He's a fighter. Trick is, time of day really can make a difference. They feed early morning or late evening because that's when the insects are more likely to be out. Okay, let's try for another. We're lucky we got such nice weather, but rain can be good. Sometimes big fish think the raindrops are insects.
Well, I guess it's still relaxing, even if I don't catch anything. Sort of like staring at the sky.
It's your bait, I think. Come use some of mine.
Oh, it's not the bait. It's me. I've always been a poor fisherman, especially compared with you and Jose.
Just try some of mine. Here. Crickets.
Thanks.
Another one. There's an angry one. Look at that. That's a good looking fish.
Well done.
Make sure he's tired before you reel in. Another one.
Damn, Javier's good at this.
Well done.
He's small, but might make a nice meal.
5 pounds.
Oh, keeping you.
It's getting close to nightfall. Fish will stop feeding soon. Let's catch a couple more and then head back. My bag is getting full.
Hmm, me, Javier.
This is an angry one. I was thinking, do you remember that stagecoach we held up in Nevada?
Yeah, it was a tip from that crooked lawman in Reno.
We opened the door and it's full of women and children. Rich, but women and children. So we let it go and read in the newspaper that
The O'Driscolls robbed and killed them all the next day, further down the trail.
Yep. You know, way back in the day, Home O'Driscoll and Dutch were sort of friends.
Friends?
Well, not friends, but they had an understanding. Then Combs' mean streak got meaner, and Dutch wanted to try to live a different way.
And now, here we are.
Well.
Let me get out of your way. You got this one. Another one.
Holy crap, Javier.
Come on. Look at that. That's a good looking fish.
Well done.
I'm gonna head back. You wanna join me, or you keep trying for these bastards?
I'll come.
Okay, let's go.
Hi there, Louie. Let me try out the new horse. Still have all my weapons, right? Yeah, you better.
We become like a god. Because to be all powerful is to be all suffering.
Yes.
Thus, Prometheus gave us light. An eternal damnation, and the awareness of our isolation for everything holy. Quite a conundrum,
Wow, I've heard him sing.
Yo no siento el que me haya.
Looking pretty well stocked now.
Thank you, Arthur.
I'll donate what I can and then click tomorrow on it.
What's wrong now?
I've seen you looking at her, Dutch.
Who?
You know who. Getting too old for you, am I? That's how it usually works with you, isn't it?
You're delusional.
again.
That was all that was.
Don't even look me in the eye, but you look at her all day.
Doesn't matter what I say, you'll believe whatever fantasy you're currently living in.
Fantasy? You think this is a fantasy for me?
I do not have the energy for this right now.
Oh, it's written all over you. I'm not stupid, I've been watching.
Oh, that much is painfully clear.
You're playing a dangerous game.
Will you be quiet? I am trying to read here.
Pig!
Hmm. Ledger. Yeah, I should increase food and water for everyone. And we got enough for the good stuff. Alright, we just need to save up later for the ammo. And then the boat eventually. Wait a minute, if I put around $60 into there, I check the ledger again. Just gotta restock everything. And then, where's that? Hell, we're gonna be more than set. Oh, fire bottles. Wait, someone's got a job. Offering for a home invasion job.
Till tomorrow.
Good morning. No. No, 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 no.
You don't look rad dressed as the law.
Hey.
Who's got the food? This is fucking.
Good morning, Arthur.
I'm sure most of that just went through. Oh, how you doing, ladies?
Hello, ladies.
Good morning.
Hello.
You look pissed off.
No more than usual.
Okay. Just checking you're all right.
Okay, Arthur.
So, what do you think of this place?
Not bad. Nice to be by the water.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, well, let's talk more later.
Yeah, goodbye.
Always good to see you.
Arthur.
You seem a bit happier.
Yes, I'm feeling good.
I'm glad.
Yes, see you later.
Hey there, Bill. You're not Bill, but
what is it?
We got something cooking you might be interested in.
Am I gonna like the sound of this?
Been cooking since Horseshoe, but you went and kicked up all that commotion at Valentine. Now, we was preparing to rob the bank there until you got involved in all that nonsense, and I don't know, I just feel like it's unfinished business.
That wasn't my fault. It was just one of them things.
How come every time I get in trouble, I'm called a fool and an idiot? But when you get in trouble, oh, it's just one of them things.
It's a good point, Arthur.
A very good point.
Right, hey. What do y'all want me to do?
Hit the goddamn bank with us.
You got a plan?
You really think it's worth going back there?
Four of us can hit the bank easy. But I ain't gonna lie to you. There will be law if we linger.
And if you're serious?
No, just local boys being rounded up and pressed into action.
Meaning?
If we go in quick and quiet, we can hit it just fine. If there's four of us, I mean.
Y'all think it's worth the risk?
It's a bank, Arthur.
So? Is the take good?
According to the fella I met, yes. It's the end of the stock sales. Plenty of money and plenty of people milling about.
Okay, I suppose. It's worth taking a look at least.
If I'm gonna be performing, I better go get changed out of these rags. Give me a minute, gentlemen.
Okay. So, Bill, this better be good.
It is good. We put a lot of research into this one.
I hope
Bill
so.
Research.
Mr. Morgan.
Herr Strauss.
That man. The debtor, Thomas Downs, apparently he's dead.
Dead? Huh. Well, he didn't seem very well.
His wife. I believe he has a wife and child. She will assume the debt, of course.
Of course.
Mm. Then you can head up there and collect. We lent them a lot of money.
Okay.
Gentlemen, let's go rob ourselves a bank.
What's the plan then?
Oh, well, we're gonna send Karen on in ahead as a distraction. Then we're just gonna rush on in afterwards. Just a small bank in a little town. Nothing that big in way of security. We just need to bring you along as a insurance policy.
Yeah, that sounds about right.
All right. Follow me.
Getting close.
Yeah.
Easy.
So, tell me again about this big can't-go-wrong plan of yours.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, it can go wrong. Anything can, once the shooting starts.
Shooting?
Well, that's reassuring.
Like I said, we'll see how it looks. If we can get in all right, we'll send Miss Jones ahead to the bank. They won't recognize her.
I'll show you boys how it's done.
What are you thinking this time?
I don't know. Fellers always like a lost little girl, but nobody plays a drunken harlot quite like me. Either should work.
Once she's got them distracted, we'll move in.
When I was scouting the place the other day, there was only a couple of guards.
Mm. We deal with them and any customers who are feeling brave. And you always fancy yourself as the mole man, right, Arthur?
Now I see why you brought me.
Hey, I'm more than willing.
Nah, best I do it.
Oh, and did Dutch tell you I've also been cooking up some deals with them gray boys?
What? No. What kind of deals?
See, you don't realize, Morgan. I'm out there putting in the work same as you.
Apparently.
I've been drinking with them a couple times now. Seems they're looking for some extra security.
Yeah, I'm sure they are.
Could be something in it for us.
Well, just be smart about it. We got a lot of irons in that fire right now.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, I know, Morgan.
So, how are you feeling about this, Lenny?
Well, at first I thought it was a bad idea. But then I figured, they all are if you think about them long enough.
Certainly have been recently.
Mm-hmm. I mean, why the hell not? Roll with it.
YOLO.
I just told them we needed you along.
I appreciate the confidence, kid.
And if we didn't rob this bank, we really would be slipping.
Thoughts like that, and you're one of us, no doubt.
Sure hope so.
All right. Guess we're doing this then. You did well. That gang and Shady Bill?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Thanks. And I heard the rest of them have moved on from there now, so we must have sent enough of a message.
I reckon so.
I ain't lose much sleep over them fellas.
Me neither.
They'd have loved nothing more than to strang me up.
That weren't gonna happen.
Well, they're dead
not
now.
Through lack of trying.
Nah,
to you. He'll outlive a lot of us. Good haul, too. That dynamite should come in real useful today.
Yeah, if we can even get near the bank without someone recognizing us and raising hell.
Well, we'll have to see about that. Just keep your eyes open. Glad you and Lenny are along for this, Karen.
Someone's got to keep you boys out of trouble.
What do you think you're doing?
Sorry, dude.
So you was just talking about something?
I ain't even sure if Lenny can be relied on to keep his head. Not after that night you two had in Valentine.
I've been trying to forget that. What little I remember of it.
You've always... been a bad drunk. And before you say it, I know, takes one to know one.
Guess we'll never learn.
And Bill ain't much better. So should we stop for some whiskey?
No.
How about we wait till after the bank, all right? Can't believe you got me going back to Valentine.
Don't tell me it ain't hurt you leaving that bank behind.
Not really.
Work a town and not hit the bank? That's downright pathetic.
I guess we went a bit beyond working it. We shot the place to hell.
You did, Morgan. Not me. I played it cool up there. Couple of punch-ups. Dealt with some old Driscolls.
Oh, is that right?
Like I said, you mess up, it's just one of them things. I mess up. I'm the prize idiot.
Well, warm, Bill.
Bill, I don't know what to tell you.
Surprised you ain't already ripped me about that dynamite again. One mistake, and I'll never live it down.
What do you need? Pat on the back? A medal?
Just know, I got the lead on this one.
We'll see about that once things get going.
Yee-haw.
Keep it down now. We're here.
Good morning.
How do you?
Gentlemen, here we are.
Okay, get ready. Hello. Karen, go to work.
Of course. All right, keep it cool and follow me, fellas.
Sorry if I'm so quiet. I'm just decided. Focused.
Is it lost little girl you want, or the drunken harlot?
Of course, you know I like the harlot.
You're the only one. You're a bunch of filthy sinners and the heartbreakers, a lot of you. Now, where is he?
You're ready. Get going.
Good luck, gentlemen.
We got this. Okay, we're going.
No, hold on. Wait till she's gotten real dead.
Sound like you don't know me. Stuck up in here. Not so goddamn stuck up last night. Oh,
I've never seen this woman in my life.
Get
your goddamn hands up!
Go!
It's a goddamn robbery!
Nobody move! Get word up! Nobody move!
Don't make us hurt you! Here! Unlock the door!
Okay, the door's unlocked.
What do you think we're here for?
Dogs, what is it? Mail.
Open the goddamn vault! Open it!
How's it looking? Are you in?
Nearly. This son of a bitch needs to get a move on!
Okay. Okay.
You goddamn slow! Son of a bitch, hurry up! Come on!
Okay.
Himself in here.
Come here. Open the lock boxes now.
The manager does that.
God damn it. Now what?
Guess I'll crack them or blow them up. Keep an eye out. I'll be as quick as I can. Yeah, I think I should be able to crack these.
All right, but you better be quick. You shut the hell up and stay still!
Slower, but it's quiet.
Okay.
Hey, watch him there.
Don't worry. I see him.
Please, let me go. I won't say nothing. I swear.
Shut the hell up and stay where you are.
How's it looking there?
Good.
Told you.
Don't count your chickens just yet.
Need to hurry up.
Another one cleared. This is looking good.
How much longer?
Nearly there.
Okay, you reckon that's enough now?
Maybe. It's never enough.
Well, I am ready to get the hell out of here whenever you are.
One.
Good. We gotta move.
I'll lead the way.
Let's go. Everybody, stay calm. All of you count to 100 and keep your mouth shut. You understand me?
Doggo, I just robbed a bank. Yes, I did. Yes, I did. My word.
Stupid and dangerous. Thank you, Bill.
We're alive and we're paid.
Yeah.
I don't see the problem.
Yeah, and that is the problem. Bill, this is a very good take. Dutch will be happy, even if it did come with a heap of trouble.
Ah, it was fun.
Well, maybe you're right. Now, go on, get out of here. I have some other business to attend to. Don't head directly back to camp, and make sure you ain't followed.
How much money was that? Oh, I gotta check on that person. much money did I get paid?
Easy, easy.
My husband's not cold in the ground, and you've come back here. Archie, I nearly paid off what was owed.
Your husband knew the rules when he took that money. Now, I'm real sorry about the way things turned out, but he had a choice. Ain't my fault about the way the world is.
He didn't have a choice. He was good, and he did good. There wasn't no choice in that. And you've as good as killed him yourself, and don't kid yourself. You had a choice.
You speak as if killing was something I cared about.
You ever wonder about eternity? Should.
I hope it's hot and terrible, Mrs. Downs. Otherwise, I'll feel I've been sold a false bill of goods. Now, please, give me that money. Either you got a lazy eye or lack of respect. Which is it, boy?
I ain't got no lazy eye. No respect for the likes of you.
Well, maybe when your mother's finished mourning your father, I'll keep her in black on your behalf. You think on that, boy?
Well, maybe you shall, sir. And maybe other events will transpire.
You best stick to them books, because mark my words on this. Vengeance is an idiot's game. Ah, Mrs. Downs, thank you for your punctuality. It's next to godliness, isn't it?
That's cleanliness.
I'll have to take your word on that. Good day.
Damn. $2,000? Okay.
Good evening. You heard about the bank in Valentine?
Yeah, sounds like it went very well. Good work, Arthur.
I'll just give like 400. Just casual.
That's my boy.
Damn. That's all decked out. That's decked out.
Good evening, Arthur.
Sure.
And fine conversation.
I need about, yeah, just another 400 to do it.
I feel the need to talk so much.
430.
Why do you feel the need for silence?
I guess I prefer people when I know not to listen to me. Point taken.
Yeah, it'll be a big hole in my pocket, but with everything done, yeah, everything's done. And at the end of the day, I still have $1,000. I believe that boat cost $400. Is there literally anything besides restocking I can get in the ledger?
Evening.
Hi, Molly.
What are you wearing? Thinking of switching to the other side?
You know, I'm sure Grimshaw could use an extra pair of hands around here.
I'm nobody's servant girl, Mr. Morgan.
Well, we all need to do our share.
I know I did. Just donated a good $1,000 into this. And now I'm rich as heck.
Good evening.
Hello.
Everything okay?
Yeah, I'm fine. Why?
No reason. Just making sure. Have you got
Mr. Morgan! Morgan!
Reverend?
Hello.
Hello.
What do you want?
What do you want?
I'm not. I'm not quite sure. Oh. This keeps happening.
Anyway, I won't disturb you.
I suppose.
Arthur. Reverend.
Hi.
Arthur.
Hey there.
Nom 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 nom.
Hello.
Excuse me.
What?
Hello, Mr. Morgan.
You okay with this spot for now, Mr. McGuire?
Ah, sure. I like to keep moving, I do. It's in me blood.
Along with a lot of whiskey. Okay, I'll catch you later then.
All right.
I was right, someone does want to rob something.
Some materials
down, affections cloud the sky.
Take the weight off. All friends here.
You busy still or got 10 fingers is a miracle. Not too busy. What?
I heard about a house. Could be interesting.
What kind of a house?
I don't know. A couple fellas I heard in town, they said it was really freakish. Family local boogeymen, I guess. But they're crooked in every way.
So?
Well, so these boys thought they were sitting on a lot of cash. And they're highway robbers, kidnappers, apparently. They're well hidden in the woods.
That sounds pretty dubious.
Of course. It's dubious, but there ain't much risk of getting caught.
Yeah.
Okay, then. Let's go take a look.
Exactly. Just take a look.
It's up north, on the other side of the river from Valentine. Best way there is through Cumberland Falls, though. You know it?
Sure, more or less. Here you go, pal.
I meant to brush him. We both got Tennessee Walkers. Oh, Jesus. Okay.
Okay, we're pretty close now. Let's stop and go on foot from here.
Just up the hill this way. Follow me.
There's a spot up ahead where we should be able to get a good look at the place. I want to make sure we don't run into any surprises.
Sure.
Apparently, this family's been isolated for so long, they started talking in their own weird dialect. They really don't like outsiders, especially on their turf.
You just keep selling me on this job, don't you?
Hmm. Oh, big place, right? You got your binoculars?
Done and freezing out here.
Well, there's a pretty big barn in the back. It's not a bad place to start looking. There must be a lot of people living here. A large house.
This desk could be in any one of them buildings, and who knows how many people are in there. I ain't sure about this.
Well, I think we need to draw them out somehow. I got an idea. Follow me.
We can light something on fire.
All these trees,
the ice is literally killing
I can't get a proper look at the place.
Well, hopefully it'll make it harder for them to spot us, too.
Coast seems clear so far.
Yeah, so far.
Hey, keep it down. I hear voices. Come on, let's hide behind the shed. See if we can hear what they're saying.
Maybe you was hunting pig this time as well. Play for a spin. Don't score ghosts in the Jiffy Fleming head.
Just stay quiet.
Where you been now, dude? Don't be boiling now, Pappy. I's gone for 10 minutes, I was.
Gag on an hour day long, because Edie takes patrol now, don't you?
What? No, Edie, get all the jam!
You shut your gumper, or I'll flag her your felt, I will.
You need to pull it up, boy. Up. Go guard the shed.
Go! You understand what they're saying?
Not much of it. What are we doing, Javier?
Okay. Take cover by the rock over there. I'll create a little distraction, then you jump them, okay?
What kind of distraction?
You'll see.
Be quiet. Knew it.
Check in there first.
Burn, baby. Oh, I have $1,000, but I'm still looting people. Ooh, a new plant?
Do you want the money or not? Come on.
You know. Let's see.
Come on, we didn't come all this.
Trouble, didn't I?
Yeah, you take this. Let's split up. I'll meet you back at camp.
Sounds good.
$175. Making some good profits here. Nui, Tarny! Dogs! Alright. Dogs? No. What the? No, no, I gotta do a thing, be right back. Alright, I am back. Well, I just did all that. Got a plan. I'm gonna head here. Pay off my debt. Then, holy crap, I'm way up north. Then, gonna head into town. See what I can't buy. And then we will be golden. Actually, since I'm heading into that town, that's where I should be heading to first. Since they got their own post office. Not familiar with these parts, so. Oh my goodness.
Yeah. Hey there, mister. Morning, fella. Well, I've been scratching the gravel today.
I need to get out of here before this place kills me. Javier, why did your lead have to be so darn far away? Like, yeah, it's paying off my debt, but still.
Yeah.
Careful, boy.
There, boy.
You're good. Okay. $120 bounty. Holy crap. Why is it telling me to go through Valentine? Yeah. We'll go around this route. What the heck in heck, game?
Okay, I just don't want him to see me. We're not friends anymore. We're not. They won't forgive you. They didn't forgive me. There is no forgiveness. None, friend. None. I know you want it. I can smell it on you.
All right. Fairly creeped out. Gonna run away. All right. Okay, now that we're here. Into battle.
Damn good shooting, senor. Thank God for you, mister. Le debo la vida.
Good luck with it.
Que alivio.
Easy now, good boy. Easy now.
Yeah.
Come on in today, boy.
destination too. So, now can I get on the main road? Thank you. Of course, it's kind of a beast. Getting closer, I can feel. Not today, dude. But later. I want to know what freaking creature that is.
Keep walking. Huh?
Hope you boys chose a full safe.
Just having a nice little break. I want to let me. Come on. Is the safe broken? Darn it. Find the freaking Rob safe and it has nothing. Pay off all my debts. Scott.
Hello again, sir. Well, quite the price tag on little old you.
All debts.
Thanks.
Absolved. I'm a free man.
Visiting old friends, I guess.
Well, you better get out of here. There's a bunch of government agents I met asking
what?
About you all across town. Yeah, them and a bunch of bounty hunters, too, I think.
So?
Yeah. Really? You don't seem too scared.
Guess not.
Well, they seem pretty mad. What would you do?
Nothing good.
Well... You better get out of here.
Damn.
Didn't expect that today. Seems I buy this near every day.
A freaking cougar? Pistol.
This here stall's as proud and fine as the town it lives in. Oh, yes.
I'll take that. Yes.
Very nice.
What the horse? No, I said follow me, but I think you're taking this flat too little.
Howdy.
Hello there.
Alright then, don't do nothing crazy, horse. Like kill another guy.
Didn't you just leave?
To make some priorities.
Let me have a look.
Let's see what we got. I actually don't want any of that. Tonics, ammo, and...
Here. Fine. Done. This here store's my whole life. That's why I drink. Mr. Ballard across the way there is doing a roaring trade all of a sudden. Maybe I ought to move. Always running out of that.
We got all black.
A lot of folks like that. That's popular. It's all good. All of it.
Right. Outfit.
What's caught your eye?
Oh, I like this.
Okay, I'm impressed. Go check on the camp. All right. Maybe I should hunt something on my way back. You want to say to me? Blew up a freaking. You okay there?
Stay here, boy. Time to go, boy.
I can't charge me up.
Easy, boy.
blow me up. Kind of small, but you know.
Not bad hunting, huh, boy?
Yeah. And I'm also going to switch that out to that. Man, they blew us up right outside of camp.
Hey there!
Bastards. First, I gotta drop off the thing.
Hey! You know something? When they were talking about hanging me, I just kept thinking of you. Oh, did you miss me? That's nice.
Don't you come here?
No.
Many thanks, Morgan. I swear I proved myself.
All right, will you take it easy? Yeah, I'm just messing. So, what are you...
Boop.
Damn. A goddamn drink.
Okay. And those platinum bling fans.
I have another drink. I can't right now. Sir, I gotta go help with the horses. Sorry. Excuse me.
With the horses? Wait a minute. Come on back. Well, come on back here, you hear? Shit.
Whatever. I'll put in like $200. That should solve it. A little more than 200. I'm going to 225.
Mrs. Adler?
Hi, Arthur.
Damn, I've got rich. There's literally nothing I can purchase. We have literally solved all of our problems. Wow. I'm gonna do this thing for Hosea, then I'm out. Freedom. Actually, I'm going to take the fireballs.
Sadie.
Hey.
I'm running a freaking armory in this thing. Alright, well now I know what we can refill on.
I like a horse well enough to not want to give one up for a machine.
Well, maybe the horse can ride in the carriage with you.
Now that's an idea.
My God, what is he putting in this slop?
He waits until the meat is crawling with lice and then he cooks it.
Oh, that explains it.
Hey, you too. Mind your manners a little. Mr. Pearson, he takes good care of us.
All right. Yeah, I forgot I was taking stuff from nice. Why you not? Oh, what the? Okay, horse. This will be my final mission for today, and then I'm done.
That's my boy.
Nui!
Hey, Arthur. What are you doing?
Hey, John.
Selling it back to where it came from.
Why?
I ain't got a market for it. They made it. They must have someone to sell it to. Stuff look kind of lonely out here. I think we'll cut ourselves a deal.
I get you.
You and Dutch was just doing your duty when you requisitioned it. Now I'm doing mine.
All right. I should get going now. I'll leave you fellas to it. Good luck.
Thank you, John. We'll see you later. Dutch asked him to look into something to do with the Braithwaite horses, I think.
Sure, okay.
Okay, let's head out to the Braithwaite's place.
You know the way?
Yeah, I've been there. So what exactly are we doing? This is the moonshine we took after blowing up the Braithwaite still, right?
I think the good citizens taking the trouble to return their stolen goods deserve some reward, don't you? And it's time we made a formal introduction, like Dutch told us. Look, these are two big old plantation houses, and all I keep hearing is they hate each other so much they can't see past it.
I know. I've seen it. There's a gray boy and a Braithwaite girl carrying on a secret affair. I've been, well, helping them.
The mind boggles. You think they're of use?
Not sure. They don't seem too involved in the rest of it, maybe.
Well, I'm sure there's money in this for us somewhere if we can get in the middle of it.
Mm-hmm. Here we are.
Modest little homestead, isn't it?
Hello, gentlemen, how are you?
What's that in the back there?
Moonshine, my fine fellow. May I have a word with the man of the house?
The man of the house is a lady. Mrs. Catherine Braithwaite.
May I speak with her? I want to discuss a business opportunity. I mean no harm. No harm at all. You may happily shoot me if I do.
Okay. She's at the house. We'll be watching you.
You heard the man. Driver, proceed, please.
Man, this is actually really beautiful if you want a plantation home.
What you want?
Found something. Out in the hills, thought maybe you was in the market for it.
For what?
Some liquor.
I ain't in the market for what's already mine.
The way we see it, it's ours. Well, with us possessing it, and I checked all over. For the life of me, I couldn't see your name on it. Whoa. Relax, I ain't here to rob you. No, it seems that's easy enough. Why don't I do a deal? What do you sell that stuff for?
$1 a bottle.
You give us 50 cents.
It's already ours.
Well, look on it as a reward for finding the property. Alternative is we go sell it someplace else.
The alternative is you get shot.
Now, who wants to get shot over a bottle or two of liquor?
Pay the man.
Sheesh. I don't like these folks.
Pleasure doing business with you. And listen, we didn't take it. At least not without orders.
I know exactly who gave you your orders. Old Sheriff Gray. You know what? I don't want it. In fact, sir, now you can do me a favor. There's an extra $10 if you do. Drive the stuff into Rhodes, head over to the tavern run by Mr. Gray, and give the stuff out for free.
Mama!
Hush now. I believe they call that a promotional expense.
As you wish, madam.
You boys come back sometime and tell me how you made out. Maybe we'll play a little cribbage.
All right. Next stop, the Rhodes Saloon.
Here we go.
So I finally sold those Cornwall bonds. Got close to 1,000 for them.
Wow.
Wanted more, but not bad considering how hot they were, especially after that bloodbath in Valentine.
No, not bad at all.
Nice.
Apparently, Cornwall's been pumping a lot of cash into the Pinkertons. Wants to keep their full effort on going after gangs. Gangs like us.
Yeah, that don't surprise me.
All right. This could get ugly. You and Dutch already have that thing going on in town with the sheriff.
Yeah, Mr. Gray.
That's it. Now we're inserting ourselves in his blood feud. We'll need something.
I ain't playing, Justin. You know how I feel about that.
Of course you're not. You're a clown's idiot brother.
Hosea, please.
I'm the clown. You're the idiot. Just look
sad and keep quiet. Even you can do that, Arthur.
Oh, I have to.
Put this hat on.
Take his hat.
Smoke this pipe. Bring your lip forward just a bit. Squint. Oh, perfect.
What about you?
Oh, shh. You can't speak. You're turned idiot. Right? Broke poor mammy's heart. There. Fenton, there. Don't get mad now.
I hate him so much, Hosea. You owe me all that bond money.
Okay, Fenton, stay calm now. For Mama, she loved you so. Just a shame you had to strangle her in a rage, right? Grab two cases of that stuff and follow me.
Operation Moonshine.
Gentlemen! Quite the town you have here. We just rode in from up north.
Hey.
Hello, I'm Melvin. This is my brother Fenton. Don't mind him. Don't madden him. He's turned idiot. Killed our mother, but it weren't his fault. How'd you boys like a couple of bucks? I bet you would. One for each of you. We're in the new trade of advertising, which is an American art form about ensuring people buy the correct things.
I don't know.
One more dollar. Says give us half an hour. What harm can we do in half an hour? Go along now. Enjoy the money. Come along, Fenton. Just hand out the liquor.
Mm-hmm.
Gentlemen! My name is Melvin. That's my brother Fenton. He's a bit funny, but boy, can he pour drinks fast. For the next 30 minutes, the drinks in this here bar, in this here town, are entirely free! Yeah. The only rule is that you gotta drink them. So hurry up, put old Fenton to work. Don't get him mad, though. His mama made him mad, and we buried her. Poor thing. Come up to the bar, everybody. Come on, fellas, it's your lucky
day. I'll have one million drinks.
A gift. Bounty. It's a shin to a lazy horse.
That's some strong stuff.
Just keep them going.
Moonshine. Down.
Bring some house for the next 30 minutes only.
Oh, wife is gonna kill me.
Come on in, have a drink. That's our goddamn liquor. And honest mistake. Boys, get him!
Oh, crap. Well, that didn't end well.
Jesus, all this over a few bottles of booze?
I reckon it's more they don't want another gang on their patch.
Okay, pull off the road here.
Man, we need a lot of that money, kind of. Sure was funny, though.
All right, we're good.
Remind me never to take up a career. What was it?
Advertising.
You think that woman set us up?
No, I didn't think so. Maybe. This place is odd.
I keep seeing those fellas.
Some local militia. Clearly not too happy to have some new competition. I'll go visit old Ma Braithwaite. See what's what.
Why?
We've been making money. The chest is filling up again, slowly but surely. Part of me thinks we just get ourselves good and lost. But we still need a lot more money before that can happen. So, for now, let me go give old Mrs. Braithwaite some of this moonshine as, well, let's call it a peace offering.
Sure.
That was fun, Fenton. We'll make an actor of you yet.
I'll go speak to Dutch. So, what do you think?
About what?
Fine folks around these parts.
Oh, real nice.
Exactly. On the one side, we have got the Gray family. Scots, degenerates, drunkards, the local law. You couldn't make this stuff up. Rich as Croesus.
And on the other, their mortal enemies, the Braithwaites. Moonshiners, hypocritical, both rolling, we believe.
In gold. And in the middle of it all, you got some inbred retelling of Romeo and Juliet.
Exactly.
So what you boys thinking?
We try to rob them both.
You sure?
Why not?
Because we got lawmen in three different states after us.
Last thing I want is to get us into trouble, but we need money. Now, we have the opportunity here to put ourselves in the middle of something. Ain't nobody gonna know we was here, because even without us, these fools are gonna kill each other anyway.
Okay, well,
we're starting a war.
To see that Braithwaite woman.
Good. Hosea should definitely take the lead on this. I sent Sean over to Braithwaite Manor, too.
It's great so far, and I got Rich.
Or join John and Javier at the Gray's place. Something to do with the Braithwaite's prize horses.
Well, how the hell did we get an inn at the Gray's place?
Sheriff Gray kindly put in a word with his father. It ain't that complicated. We gotta convince each family that we're on their side. And then we rob them both. Before they figure out it was us that done it, and not the other lot, we'll be long gone. Think of it as payback for my daddy.
Payback? I ain't in the revenge business, Dutch. Least of all for something happened a long time ago.
Well, I guess we all gotta pay for something. Now,
nice.
Excuse me, Arthur. I got to write a letter.
Advertising the new American art, too.
You're beginning to creep me out, Arthur.
Whoa, that's a lot of reading. I know, it's weird to think of it so close.
Mrs. Adler. Miss Adler. How are you?
Oh. Do 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 do. Hey, Sadie.
This is it.
Hi.
Where is my soup? Let's see what we got. Me too. Now, Lucy, since you're here, good question. Do we go to Braithwaite with Hosea? Or do we go to John Marston in the Gray State? I'm going to be messing around with these people into the answer, but yeah.
I see all them long faces and sour expressions, but you're forgetting
okay,
one thing.
Okay, Mr. Morgan.
It's a good time to be alive.
Fairson.
Are the best of times for men such as us. This is the age of science, the age of reason, the age where a man can be what he wants, irrelevant to birth or other restrictions, like intelligence. Half you fellas don't realize how lucky you are.
Hi,
this is a free
about
time.
About time you rested up.
I'm sure.
You still glad you joined up with us?
Of course. You're gonna be fine. I was telling one of those lovely ladies
glad
just
to have
now.
You.
Bye, Arthur. Cry sugar, I told her. Because they lied at that. Anyway, don't cry, I said. Uncle loves you. One day, you won't be no $3 whore. You're going to be a $5 whore or a house.
Yeah, probably with John Marston. Because, Marston.
All right, go on. It ain't like you got balls anyway.
Oh, hell's half acre. Oh, here and here.
Did he just leave?
Oh, my balls. Like, that'd be enough.
Nom 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 nom. I love the suit. Again, Arthur Morgan. Man run entirely on coffee. Retrieve the Tennessee Walk. All right. Now to John Marston. I gotta be careful around here. People keep trying to kill me thinking it's a great idea. Bit of life advice. It's not. Oh, don't tell me they're back. Yeah, this shotgun should spook him right and nice. Oh, it's just a camp.
You.
Okay, you're not them.
What did I tell you? Get the hell out of here.
Calm down.
Mm-hmm.
You can help us. Ain't like this is going well.
Really?
Oh, wait.
Shit. Nothing to lose, I suppose. Come on. The truth is, mister, our last batch of shine didn't turn out so good. You think you can help us with locating some ingredients? We could reward you for your troubles.
Sure, why not?
You know, wild tobacco might give us the rich, earthy flavor we are looking for.
Oh, yeah? I have some with me.
Nice.
Go on, lazy bones. Toss the plants into the batch so we can test it out.
Oh my goodness, my horse is just right here.
All right. I'm gonna give this a taste.
So tasty, but dang if I don't get a prickly feeling. Real sharp.
Mm.
Well, that sounds
kinda interesting. Why don't we rest up a spell, and then whip up another batch later on? We got a rare victual in that chest there. Take it. I'd say you earned it.
Very generous, thanks.
What am I looking for? Oh, it's right here. Yeah, it did. So if you're gonna do it, be prepared.
Yeah.
We ride. Okay, make sure there's not another trap. Oh, it's fun. Hell, this game made me enjoy fishing. My least enjoyed activity.
Yeah. Easy boy.
Supposed to be my business partners here. They arranged a meeting, I believe, about some horses.
A fellow with a scar and a Mexican.
Yes, sir.
Yep.
Out by the stables.
Thank you. Have a wonderful day now.
Good men, like you.
You don't know me. You turn up in this town, and you're helping everybody. And everywhere, there's troubles.
And have you met my partner, Arthur Morgan?
No.
I met your son, the sheriff.
Okay.
Mr. Gray here was saying how he had problems with a family. A family of degenerates.
Oh, well, nobody likes degenerates.
Hag and her inbred sons. They ruined this county. They killed my uncle, you know.
That ain't right.
Problem is, we can't be seen to get too close.
And?
We've got gold, Yankee. We've got gold.
I ain't no Yankee, friend. I ain't nothing. My daddy came over on the boat from Scotland.
I'm Scottish.
And the Braithwaites?
Goddamn peasants! I don't know. Mongrels!
We learned something about our good old boy, John.
All you gotta do is look at him.
How much gold?
Enough. These are prized horses I'm talking about. Them, they'll get you 5,000.
5,000? For horses?
Easy.
And where do we sell them, these $5,000 horses?
Over in Clemens Cove. Fellow over there will run them out of state and give you 50 cents on the dollar.
Mister, you got yourself a deal.
Just keep us away from this. Publicly, I mean.
My sense is we keep all horse wrestling away from the public.
I love John. Like, I'm liking Arthur, but...
The stables on the south side of the map. That's where they keep the thoroughbred.
But it's John Marston. And Javier Esquila.
Crazy old fool.
Mm-hmm.
You should see the Braithwaite woman.
Jose and Sean are planning on going over to the Braithwaites.
I know.
You haven't seen them?
No, not yet. If they're there already, they better keep their heads down. We don't need this to be any more complicated than it already is.
$5,000 for horses. We've been robbing the wrong folk all these years.
Yeah, he doesn't know what he's talking about. But if we get even a third of that, it'll be worth it.
Mm-hmm.
So how are we gonna play this?
The place is well guarded, so there ain't no point in blasting in there. Make them think we're there looking to purchase.
Three armed men?
You'd be armed if you were about to spend $5,000 on horses. We should go in the back way, though. Avoid too many questions.
You're a good boy.
Tranquilo.
Guard.
I'll speak to him, okay?
All right, then.
Can I help you, gentlemen?
Yeah, we're here to see about some horses.
Horses?
Yeah, we had an appointment with Mr. Braithwaite, I believe.
Yeah, I never heard about any of this.
A partner wanted to make a significant investment in some stables down here. But perhaps we should look elsewhere.
Well, I... Okay, then. Head on up to the stables. Someone will come see you.
Nice. Like stealing baby from a candy. Yeah, we're gonna light this place up, aren't we?
Alright, I think that's the stables just up ahead. Heads down, play cool. Head around the front, hitch up there. Alright, let's hitch up here. Real good, boy. Let me do the talk. Hello there.
Can I help you, boys?
I hope so. Heard you got some horses.
We always got horses.
Fine horses, I mean.
I don't get you, friend.
Yeah, you do. Come on.
Listen, why don't you get out of here? You, Scarface, and your greaser buddy.
Whoa!
I don't like officials.
We ain't officials. We're connoisseurs, looking to do some breedings. Come on now, partner.
Okay, fine. Follow me. These here's mainly the studs available for purchase or for working. That's what you're interested in. What is you boys interested in?
We represent a famous stable and stud farm from Saratoga.
Is that so?
Unofficially.
Saratoga.
Of course. This here's Cerberus. Here you go, boy.
Hey, how you doing, Cerberus?
Okay, bandana's on. Don't... Nobody recognizes us.
All right, I'll grab the white one in the middle. You get the other two.
Oh, John's still using his line.
Javier's horse.
Easy. It's okay.
Okay. Javier, you're gonna lead the stallions. There, boy.
Okay, the horse didn't like my pet.
This here's Cerberus.
Here you go, boy.
I like the white horsey. Snap.
Greaser, huh?
Okay, bandana's on. Don't need nobody recognizing us.
All right, I'll grab the white one in the middle. You get the other two. Relax, boy. Come on.
Good boy.
Whoa, easy.
Easy now.
Whoa, now, easy. Marston, you're gonna tether him up to Javier's horse.
Okay.
Javier, you're gonna lead the stallions.
Whoa.
Okay, boy.
This here's Cerberus.
Here you go, boy.
Greaser, huh?
Okay. Bandana's on. Don't need nobody recognizing us.
All right. I'll grab the white one in the middle. You get the other two. Relax, boy. Come on.
Good boy.
Easy there. Easy.
Easy now. Easy. It's okay.
Marston, you're going to tether him up to Javier's horse.
Okay.
Javier, you're going to lead the stallions.
Calm down, horse.
Go easy, boy.
How much love does this horse need?
Okay, bandana's on. Don't need nobody recognizing us.
All right, I'll grab the white one in the middle. You get the other two. Relax, boy. Come on.
Good boy.
Easy.
Easy now.
Take it easy. Marston, you're going to tether him up to Javier's horse.
Okay.
Javier, you're going to lead the stallions.
Whoa, now, easy.
Easy. You're okay. Whoa, whoa, easy. Hey, easy now.
Whoa.
Wait, you're telling me the lasso won't work on the horse? What kind of horse are you?
You're okay. Easy, boy.
Lead the horse. What is wrong with this demon horse?
It's okay.
Oh, for flipping, dodging, neck something.
Marston, you right point. I'll cover up the back. If there's any problems, regroup at Clemens Cove.
Okay.
What are you doing?
Let's go, quick!
Get going, you two!
What the hell are you doing? Stop! I said stop these men! Stop!
Damn it. Come on, horse.
Well done. Fleming's Cove's just over there. Come on. Let's get this over with.
Well, that could have gone smoother.
That'll be on my gravestone. You think they look like they're paying $5,000 for horses?
I guess we'll see.
What you boys want?
Heard you pay good prices for horses.
Oh, we'll buy more or less anything, Pop.
That so?
Sure, Pop. I'm Clay Davies. That's my brother Clive. We're twins.
John, Arthur, Javier.
So what are you? Cuban?
No.
I don't like Cubans.
That so?
Maybe. Why, what do you care? You ain't Cuban.
Maybe I like Cubans.
Ooh, you're funny. He's funny. Ain't he funny, Clive? Clive don't talk. We're twins, but I was born first. He came out all yellow and black, but he's okay.
Sure.
Yeah, I know these horses. They ain't yours. But I like you, and I'll give you... I'd give you 654.
I was told we could get up to $5,000 for them.
And I was told the moon was made of ladies' tears. Only it ain't true. Not one little bit.
But...
I like you boys. But I ain't got more than 700 on me. You want it, or you want to ride them fellers into town, and maybe someone there will hang you.
We're gonna need more than that.
I ain't got no more money, Pop. Here, take it or leave it.
All right.
You goddamn fool, Marston.
Ain't no one around here got $5,000, boys, but nice meeting you. See you boys again, I hope. Come on. Yeah. Close the gate, Clive.
Well, that was a bust.
Believe the yarn spun us by one of that Gray family. And imagined we was gonna be wonderfully rich. At the end of it, we felt like prize idiots.
I got 116 bucks out of that, but still feel like a fool. Oh well, that's gonna be it for me today. Oh well, this is where I'm gonna end it, everyone. Nice seeing you, and everyone else have a good time. Bye.